Welcome back to Newsmakers. The Ferrymead workshops are a hotbed of activity at the moment as a group of passionate train enthusiasts beaver away on restoring old rail stock that will be showcased in the National Railway Museum. Now, this exciting new attraction is set to open in 3 years' time. Much of the initial work has been completed out of the public gaze. So what's in store? Well, joining us is the chairman of the National Railway Museum, John Peterson, and the Collections Department head, Colin Dash. Thank you very much for joining us.
Michael.
John, would it be fair to say that the development of this museum has been unfolding largely under the radar?
Yes, it would. In fact, it goes back to more than 40 years ago when the group that is now the Canterbury Railway Society started building infrastructure, rail infrastructure, at what is now Ferrymead Park, even before there was a Ferrymead Park. They started building out in the mud, and there's a reason for that we'll talk about a little bit later on, but the fact is that the museum is, in fact, a project that is now 40 years in the planning, but only now really getting off the ground.
Fantastic. And what brought about the inception of the idea of having a National Railway Museum?
Well, that was really pretty much the goal of the people that got started more than 40 years ago, and
right.
That was to build a formal museum.
Yeah.
They needed the infrastructure because it was also going to be a living museum as well. And so the fact is that what they've been doing out there has been building toward this for some time. The fact that it's a National Railway Museum is the fact that we've got the largest collection in New Zealand, the largest support base of volunteers and members of the Railway Society, and the site and the location of the museum are historically significant as well. So a lot of things come together in one place.
Yeah. Just tell us about Ferrymead and its history when it comes to rail and its importance to rail heritage in New Zealand.
Well, Ferrymead is the location of the very first public railway in New Zealand back to 1863. It was a railway that was intended to only be short term, and it lasted for 10 years until 1873. And as Colin will be able to tell you in a good bit more detail, the fact that it's there and lasted for that period of time and the site is now rail significant means that that's a good place to put it.
Sure.
And it's also an area that's not set aside for museums, so it's an easy place for it to get resource consent. And the fact that we've got the Canterbury Railway Society's infrastructure already there means that it's a logical place. We have a tie into the Kiwi Rail main network, so we can get track and rolling stock in and out. So it works from a number of viewpoints.
Yeah. Colin, what's your background? Tell us about your life story in 30 seconds or less it comes to rail.
Rail, well, probably started off with a usual Hornby train set, you know, as being a little junior. But
yeah.
For a long time, I wasn't that interested in rail, but sort of came into being again through into my 20s and that, and got involved with Ferrymead, which was become a passion. I've been there 40 years at Ferrymead now, which is not bad going. And the history of railways in New Zealand is quite fascinating. It's part of the total history of the country, not just part of the railway history.
Do you think that the wider public underappreciate rail's role in the development of New Zealand?
I'm sure they do.
Yeah.
Yes.
And obviously, part and parcel of having a formalised National Railway Museum will be to very much showcase a lot of that, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. It's to bring to people's attention what exactly the railways did do for the country, and to bring up all that, keep that as a historical document or place where people can go and study it or see it or whatever.
Sure. John?
Rail played a tremendous part in the development of the country. Whole areas of the country, the Mackenzie, Otago, West Coast goldfields, would not have been able to open up were it not for rail. The fact that we're still taking coal out of the West Coast, it means that that's all feasible. At one point, rail was New Zealand's second largest employer, only second to the post office, contributed hugely to the GDP of the country. Training, fully 25% of rail employees were Maori, which meant there were training abilities and opportunities open there that just didn't exist in other industries. So from a number of viewpoints, rail has been a huge, huge contributor to the country, and that part of it has just quietly been ignored. In fact, you can't even find that reference except a very few books that are only now becoming available that begin to talk about it.
Sure. Now, after the break, we'll get Colin to provide some insights on some of the key exhibits that are being worked on and being prepared for the National Railway Museum. Before we go to the break, though, just tell us a bit about the building. I know we've got some images of how this museum will look as it takes shape in the next few years at Ferrymead. Who designed it, by the way?
It's designed by local architect Peter Bevan.
Yep.
It's a multi-part building, so that there is a major display area, which is in the form of a railway roundhouse. That's a huge building. It's about 250 feet across.
Wow.
Has a big turntable in the middle so that the exhibits fan out like spokes in a wheel, and the turntable in the middle gets them into the various tracks. There'll be a full archive and a proper put together library, a gift shop, snack shop, obviously a reception and administration area, and that will be built over a period of years in stages.
Fabulous. Has the construction of the building started yet?
No.
When will that start?
We're hoping to be able to do some sort of groundwork. Well, actually, we've started the preliminary groundwork, but the groundwork in earnest a little later this year or perhaps early next year. That depends on funding, obviously.
Yeah.
The first stage is going to be the big railway roundhouse, because that's the bulk of the display area. We'll put temporary administration and so forth together based on that. So that's really the focus, is to get the roundhouse built and open by 2013, and that's doable. That's feasible for us.
Fantastic. What's the price tag for this project?
Just under $4 million, and we've got about 10% of that already committed in sponsorship and fundraising.
Great. All right. After the break, we'll tell you about some of the showpiece exhibits that will be part of this museum. We'll be back with our rail buffs very shortly. Do stay with us.